July 11, 2018.
Okay, this completely the Shih Tzu, right? This Shih Tzu, female sterilized, about 8 years old, was adopted last year, right? How many months ago?
February last year.
From a pet shop. And the dog was okay. So there was no medical problems. The dog ate well, right? But ate more than normal? I mean more than the other dog?
No, I keep the portion the same.
Vary the position. The same, huh?
Yeah.
Okay. So, drinks more?
Yeah, drinks.
Okay. So, for that last year, there's no problem until when? Last week?
Until last week, Wednesday.
Last week, Wednesday. Today is
Wednesday.
So, 7 days ago, every evening, right?
Yeah.
When the owner comes back, during the daytime, the owner is not back. So, every evening, the owner noticed that when the dog gets up, right, to stand up, she will scream.
Yeah.
And shiver, right? Shivering.
Yes.
Scream for a few seconds, isn't it?
Just a short while.
And then shiver.
Yeah, shiver.
Shiver for some time?
Yeah.
According to the owner, the shivering is like this way, you see it? The shoulder shivering. This one, this way?
Yeah, this way.
Not very obvious one, right?
No, unless you carry it, then you can feel it.
Any saliva coming out from mom?
No.
No. Okay, now doing the examination now. We have a quick examination. Mucous membrane. The temperature taken, no fever. No fever, right? The membrane. But this one, actually, the teeth is bad now. They're tartar here. But the gums are alright. You can see that it's not... dehydrated. Overall, any problem with the tartar here? Okay. Let me check the throat. Any coughing?
No.
Submandibular lymph nodes enlarged both sides. Huh? So there may be some infection of the mouth early on. Check for any coughing? No. Okay, then it's finished. So now I'll just check the lymph nodes. Quick one. Any submandibular enlarged? This one, check nothing. Prescapula. Armpit one. Axillary. No enlargement. Goes down. And have a quick check on the popliteal to confirm there is no enlargement. No, so the lymph nodes is okay. Now I will check the heart and lungs quickly. Heart is okay. Normal. Lungs. Normal, no sounds. No lungs. Abnormal lung sounds. Abdomen. Some sounds. Now, the dog has not been passing motion for 2 days or 3 days.
Only 2 days.
I'm going to abdominal palpation. Check the kidney. And any pain. So if there's pain, then the dog will scream. Quick check. Sorry, abdominal anterior. Just to feel the kidney first. The left kidney normally can be felt. But nothing, no pain. Stomach. Liver, spleen. No enlargement. No, but there's one big swelling here. Has the dog pee or not?
Today have not pee.
Pee could be the bladder. But generally, no pain. Okay. You can walk, right? No problem, right?
Don't walk much nowadays.
Okay. So I will just check the spinal column, the quick one. Some hunchback, some pain here. Otherwise the back will be hunched. Only the back is straight. I'll tell one more time. Here, the pain is here. You can see the back arch.
Mm-hmm.
So, So the thing is, the dog lies down, and then we try to get up, the pain is here. So it screams, and then, of course, the pain is shivering. Now, this one is probably a sleep disc, but not serious. So the dog can still walk normally, still walk normally?
Walk normal, but if lie down already, then when he stand up, he don't intend to
eat. Okay, we can show him here. Now, can the dog walk? Let's see. See, he walks normally. And, okay, bring it up. Huh? So, the good news is that we can locate the pain, which I can locate it, I can repeat it again. So I should try to do it again and show. Now we see it's level. Go down a bit to video the level. Okay. So now it's level. So I will do it again. And this one is very, not very obvious, the pain. There seems to be some pain here as well. Did it all fall down?
No.
Climb upstairs, downstairs?
No.
Here the pain starts. The dog has some punching of the back. And so the good news is that it's only something only. And the reason I cannot tell you, do you go down the stairs, run downstairs, upstairs over the last weeks? Never go upstairs and downstairs?
No, he only walk normal floor only, never climb staircase.
You only bring her down?
Bring her downstairs, walk only, never climb staircase. No staircase.
Please come, hold the dog. But you hold the dog upside down, come. Ready? One, two, three, turn upside down. Hold the head, Put down your. Just hold like that. Hold armpit. Okay, just hold on. Just hold armpit. Just check below. Okay. Now, the bladder is full. Now, let's see any discharge or not. Okay, relax first. Now, the when was the last, the vet check up the last one? Which month was it?
That's
on the form. The ultrasound.
31st March.
May, so isn't it recently at the time? That time the dog has a complaint of blood in the urine. So this could be related to the urination. So the pain could be both sides, urine, the bladder. But the main thing is here. So if you want to do an x-ray this area, see whether there is anything there, like slip disc or some growth or any abnormality here. And at the same time, I empty the bladder first, take the urine test, and then when the bladder is empty, I think the x-ray is better, then we can see the bladder as well. The wall is thickened according to the ultrasound. Then after that, then we will come to a conclusion of the blood test as well. Then there's no stools inside no stool, surprisingly, you say the dog was eating in the morning, right?
This morning, I think.
Like last 2 mornings?
Yeah.
But there are no stools. So maybe the dog passed motion, you didn't know?
No, not I know. Because when I come back, I don't see it. Normally, she will do it at that place, but don't have it.
Does it eat the old stools?
No.
Some dogs do, though.
No, this one totally don't.
So this one is okay, this side. So overall, I will just repeat the test again. Okay, now you can see this. Relax first, okay? Okay, one more time, I will just do this part. And then I'll feel it worse. Some dogs can tolerate pain.
This one can tolerate pain.
So they didn't show. They can protect themselves, they don't people to know. Okay, so we'll stop, and then the test will be x-ray, blood test and urine test. So we'll make sure we can collect the urine because the bladder is full. So definitely we'll check the urine for blood in the urine, like last month, not June.
May.
The other vet, but the vet didn't take a urine, right?
The dump, yes, do.
You take?
They take. The urine test.
Did you catheterize it or not? Did you report?
No report for me.
Okay, so we will do this three things, the urine test, x-ray and blood test to come to a conclusion. Okay, finish.